Hi everyone, it's Niamh here and welcome to my art journaling channel. Today we're going to be playing around with a Halloween colour palette. So I'm starting off in my craft journal. This is a small 6x6 one and I'm just pasting on some gesso just to sort of give a bit of brightness in the background and drying that off. I'm also going to add some collage papers. So I'm starting off with some vintage papers. Again, just to add a little bit of a background, I didn't really have much of an idea of what I wanted to do, but I did know I wanted to explore this sort of Halloween-y type color scheme, which is kind of inspired from the page you can see on the right-hand side. So I'm starting off with some fuchsia, and I'm watering it down so it's quite light, quite soft in the background. And you can sort of see the difference between having the fuchsia on the gesso and the fuchsia on straight onto the craft background. So where the gesso is, the page is sealed and also it's got that white in the background, so it makes the color almost true to life. Where it goes onto the craft, it's unsealed, so it sort of sinks into the page, but also it's obviously on a brownie background, so you're getting that brown tone through the color. Sorry, I knocked my camera, so it's gone off slightly on a different angle here. Now I've just gone in with a little bit of tangerine, which is an orangey color, through a stencil. So just adding a little bit of brightness to the page. And again, you can sort of see the difference between having that on a sealed surface and on the gesso or the collage paper, which is also sealed with a gel medium. So if you don't want to have white in the background, but you do have collage, or you want to have the sort of that brownie color, you can seal the page using clear gel medium. It'll turn the craft paper slightly darker brown, but it will keep it as much as possible. I've then gone in with my blackberry spray and sprayed through my journal and then wiped off the excess just to get some different colored prints. And then I've gone in with some white with my paint pen to add some detail as well. So I decided I was going to stamp onto this page, and I'm using this large face. Now, one of the things I really like about the craft journal is it's actually a really great paper to stamp straight onto, or a cardboard to stamp straight onto. You get a really lovely impression straight away. So I'm pressing down quite firmly onto the page. This is sort of the beginning of my journal, so that's why the whole page whole book tipped over. And then I'm just drying it off. Even though it is permanent ink, it still stays wet for a little bit, and I'm impatient. You can see I'm sort of wanting to go in my white pen and do some doodling over the top, so I wanted to have my page dry. So I'm going in and adding some highlights, adding some sketchy lines over the top. By adding the white over the black, it sort of adds that brightness like a highlight to it, and it leaves the black as the shadows, which I really like. I'm also going in with a little bit of my Stabilo oil pencil in red, and I had a little bit of a neon green to add the pupils of the eye. Irises of the eye. No pupils. I can't remember which bit's the coloured bit. Whatever bit the coloured bit is, I added it in green. So what I'm doing now is trying to find a quote to go on the page, because I didn't want to add too much else to this. And I'm not really a Halloween-y person, so I had to sort of look up a quote I wanted to. And I think the keywords I looked up was quirky, scary, or Halloween, sarcastic, possibly, or snarky Halloween quotes. So I look up my quotes on Pinterest, because there's usually a really good load of them on there. And I found this one. So I've drawn out my quote with my paint pen first of all, just with thin lines, and then I'm going in and extending my letters so it fits into the page a little bit more. So I've got "Life is scary, find your boo" for this page, because it kind of looks very booish, the face. If you're looking for the face, it's a Dina Wakeley stamp. That's where that came from. So just drying that off, and then I'm going in with a alcohol marker in a warm grey colour. And then it wasn't really giving me the boost I wanted, so I'm going in with a purple. So the reason I'm using an alcohol marker is because it's a transparent ink, So you can sort of still see it, but it gives you that pop of color. And this is going to give me my sort of shadow to my page. And then I'm going in with my white pen to give a highlight. And this just helps to give a sort of really 3D effect. It really pushes your letters to the front, and it's a fun way to add a boost of color really easily. You'll see also with this, I have overlapped the Y, the loop of the Y, with the extension of the D, just, you know, because I needed extra room on the page. So in the close-up, you can see the texture, you can see that gloss spray, you can see the brightness of it, how I've drawn over the stamped image, which is a really great way to sort of get an overall effect, and how that using the alcohol marker as a bit of a shadow on my fonts help push it towards the front. So I hope you have a go at playing with Halloween colors. It's a fun way to push yourself outside and use different palettes that you're not used to using. Until next time, bye for now.